Hi there, this is U.S. Representative Rick Larsen with my weekly Recap with Rick. I'm out here in Skagit County at the Judy Reservoir, located in East Skagit County outside of Sedro-Woolley. And this is where the Skagit County PUD had their pumping station. Behind me you see what are called clear wells, and the Judy Reservoir is up the hill, providing about 1.5 billion gallons of water for communities throughout Skagit County. The reservoir is operated by the hardworking women and men at the Skagit County PUD number one, district number one. And I took a tour of the PUD's water treatment facility, of the reservoir itself, and at a major pipeline, water pipeline construction project where they're replacing existing pipeline, partly funded by the Environmental Protection Agency's Drinking Water State Revolving Fund money. And as they expand their pipeline replacement project, they'll be looking at that particular fund as well. Very critical and important, because as part of the bipartisan infrastructure law, to have clean water investments as part of infrastructure. And I have had a series of meetings today with local stakeholders. A lot of people leaving work today. I'm just waving goodbye. Local stakeholders about infrastructure here in Skagit County, including Skagit Transit, the port of Skagit County, and we talked about broadband expansion, and with the city of Anacortes, also talked about clean water infrastructure, all very critical to infrastructure investment and creating jobs. All told, this week I've held 11 in-person or virtual events to highlight how important the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act is. On Monday, Tuesday, and today is Wednesday, every day is Infrastructure Day in the 2nd Congressional District here in Washington State. Every day. And the Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act helped make that happen. This now marks my 35th and final Recap with Rick of 2021. I want everyone to enjoy the holidays. Merry Christmas. Happy Kwanzaa, and have a